I'm Colin Stuart. I'm an astronomy author and speaker. In our everyday lives, space and time, they seem very different things. So, for example, we have quite a lot of freedom in space. We can choose the direction we travel in. We can stop, turn around, and go back the other way. We can change the speed at which we move through space. So I can walk or run, get in a car, a plane, or a rocket ship. We don't seem to have that freedom in time. We seem to be stuck traveling in the same direction at a constant rate. But the thing is, we've known for over 100 years that that's not true. That actually space and time aren't so different. That they're united together into something we call space-time. Now, one way to think about space-time is that it's like a stage on which all events in the universe play out. So I want you to imagine that you're running a 100-meter race with Usain Bolt. Would you be surprised if I told you he got to the finishing line before you? I doubt it, because famously he can move through space faster than you. But you're not actually racing through space. You're racing through space-time. So he gets through space faster than you, but he also gets through time faster than you. By getting to the finishing line first, he gets to the future first. And that seems wrong, it feels wrong. But we've done countless experiments that tell us that this kind of time travel to the future is not only possible, but it's already been done. This time travel might seem like abstract physics, but it's something you rely on all the time. When we open our phones and open the Maps app and push that button that tells us where we are on the Earth, that only works because your phone receives signals from the GPS satellites. They have very accurate atomic clocks on board to time the signals. We have to alter the clocks. We have to artificially change the time on those clocks because they are getting through space-time faster than us. So time travel isn't just possible. You rely on it every time you push that button on your phone. So one of the first pieces of evidence for this time dilation, as it's called, came from putting an atomic clock on a jumbo jet and flying it around the world. So they synced up the atomic clocks on the ground, made sure they were telling the right time, flew some on a big loop around the Earth, brought them back together, and they told different times. And the discrepancy between the two clocks was exactly what Einstein said they'd be with his theories of relativity. If you'd like to find out more about the physics of time travel, you can find out more in my book, Time, 10 Things You Should Know.